There's a damning new report on the treatment of asylum seekers, especially children, at Australia's offshore detention center on the Pacific island of Nauru. Documents leaked to the Guardian newspaper highlight 2,000 cases, including reports of assault, sexual abuse, and child abuse. CNN cannot confirm the authenticity, but the allegations match those made by Human Rights Watch. And Amnesty International says they detail a dysfunctional and cruel system. But the Australian government told CNN many of the reports reflect unconfirmed allegations. Now, earlier, I spoke to The Guardian's Paul Farrell in Sydney and began by asking him about what the leaked documents reveal.
There are constant allegations and reports of self-harm attempts, of sexual assault allegations, of abuse, all kinds of horrible things. And it is a truly staggering read. I mean, this is the largest leak we've ever seen from inside Australia's detention network. And it really paints a picture that is quite devastating.
The size of the leak is staggering, and the details as well. And we learned that children are really bearing the brunt of the abuse at Nauru.
One of the things that is really striking about these reports is that even though children only make up 10% of the population on Nauru, they make up 50% of the reports of serious incidents contained in these reports. I mean, that's massively disproportionate, and it shows that there are very serious incidents of sexual assaults, of self-harm, of abuse happening to these children in Australia's care.
And the leaked documents also contain disturbing details of behavior by traumatized children, including a girl who had sewn her lips shut. Is this actually happening?
This absolutely is happening, and what the files show is that it's happening with alarming frequency. It's common throughout those reports to see cases of young children or young girls sewing their lips together or beginning to trying to slash their wrists. It's really staggering. And sometimes what's even more staggering is the response to those. I mean, there's one report that really stuck with me, which is of a young girl who sewed her lips together. And then she said that a guard came up to her and just started laughing at her. So they show a really difficult picture. And while there are certainly some caseworkers there who seem to really care about the asylum seekers and want to take care of them, they do show a really cruel side to Australia, I think.
And what does the leak show about the sexual assault of women at Nauru? How big an issue is that?
The sexual assault of women remains a serious issue on Nauru. And this is despite an Australian parliamentary inquiry into this precise issue. It's despite a Human Rights Commission report into it. It's despite other reviews. It shows that these reports are continuing. They've continued beyond that. And the Australian government hasn't stopped it. And that is really alarming.
And after reading just pages and pages of the ongoing abuse in these leaked files taking place at this detention facility at Nauru, how do you answer the question, what went wrong and who is ultimately responsible?
The buck stops with Australia. It's trying to outsource its asylum seekers to another Pacific nation. It's trying to outsource its asylum seekers to private companies. But at the end of the day, the buck stops with the Australian government.
It has been so difficult to get detailed information about conditions at this camp in Nauru. How did this leak come to light?
There are vast numbers of former staff and people linked to the detention system who are so frustrated and so infuriated by what they've seen and witnessed and what they know that the Australian government isn't aware of going on in these detention camps. And the reality is there are huge impediments to getting out even the most basic information. And people have had enough of it. And many people have taken the step of speaking out.
And that was Paul Farrell from The Guardian speaking to me earlier. Now, one of the companies that provides detention services on Nauru told CNN it's dealt appropriately with all the allegations. No response yet from a second provider.